Good afternoon and a very warm welcome to Merton College Chapel for today's organ recital. I'd like to mention that next Thursday, our junior organ scholar, Francois Quintin, will be playing a programme which includes Messiaen's great cycle for the Feast of the Ascension, which is indeed next Thursday. So please do join us this time next week. It's a great pleasure to welcome today David Good to give the organ recital. David spent some time in Oxford as sub-organist in Christ Church, and so we're thrilled to welcome him back to the city for today's concert. Please give him a very warm welcome. instrument. I remember coming to the opening recital I brought some students in 2014, and great to be here with you today. And many thanks to all who've made it possible, to Ben and Francois and those at the college. It's been nothing but a pleasure. That was, of course, Mozart's cracking Figaro overture, a wonderful piece to set us sort of in high spirits, which I arranged sort of late last year. This organ is going to be put through its paces today in various ways, showing its tremendous versatility. I very recently, only a couple of weeks ago, was recording Mozart's organ works, which is a slightly complicated concept, which if you've got several hours free, I'll probably be on the subject. Not in fact including that piece, but various fragments and some wonderful masterpieces that Mozart wrote for different kinds of instruments, essentially. And I'm going to play two little pieces now. First, for a glass harmonica, something of a curiosity, which is essentially that thing where you go round the rim of a wine glass or some glass, and it makes a sound, and that's put together in a machine. And it was very popular, along with all kinds of automata, in the late 18th century. So Mozart wrote this very short, just a few bars, beautiful little adagio for the instrument. And also then a little jig, which is a fugue, very quirky, chromatic fugue, very energetic, somewhat after the manner of Handel. Mozart was becoming very interested in fugues at a certain period in his life and wrote quite a lot of them. So two little pieces by Mozart. And then to Max Reger, whose 150th anniversary it is this year, his birth. Reger wrote a large quantity of organ music, much of it long, loud, and formidable. Neither piece that I'm going to play is those things. They are fairly short, these two pieces, and among his most accessible, I think. The Ave Maria is very gentle. Meditation shows a charming kind of devotional aspect, essentially a solo cantilena for the right hand. Not without, of course, chromatic twists and turns. Wouldn't be Reger otherwise, but it's a lovely piece. And then the Scherzo in D minor, very engaging, bustling sort of piece, rumbustious, with a short trio section in the middle, rather mysterious, with a descending chromatic scale running through it. So two of my favourite shorter Reger pieces, I think, there. Then a suite by Fred Viner, Frederick Viner, who I got to know as a colleague a few years ago, and he also has a York as well as an Oxford connection in terms of his studies. He's emerging as one of today's significant young composers. I was asked to mark the 50th anniversary of the concert hall organ in the University of York, just before the pandemic, how long ago now that seems, and I asked Fred to write me a piece as playing various pieces of the York connection. So this is Ebor Excursions, Ebor from the Latin for York, and it's in three movements. The first is a prelude, they're only 2 or 3 minutes long each movement, which has a lot of colour but seems to set up something for later. Then a very beautiful nocturne, it's a gentle kind of contemplation in the middle, and then the last movement is dance, which is energetic and uplifting, as the title suggests, and rather jazzy. I think Fred is a splendid composer, intelligent and rather witty in his harmony and full of interesting ideas, so I hope you enjoy this piece. And thus to Brahms to finish. Wonderful fugue in A flat minor. Young Brahms made an intensive study of counterpoint, and this is from that period, although one can be forgiven for thinking of the work of a sort of older composer, but it's wonderfully mature and serious, full of pathos, very chromatic, in this unusual key of A flat minor with 7 flats. Which doesn't need to bother anyone except one can hear some of the sort of dark atmosphere in the piece. I think it's one of his most beautiful pieces, so do enjoy that. And then By way of symmetry, we end with another transcription, and this is of the Academic Festival Overture. I thought you can't come to Oxford, and I nearly said the second best university in the world, the best university in the world, I'll be generous, and not play something academic. So this is Brahms's piece. He was given an honorary doctorate. He was asked to write a symphony. He jibbed at that, but did write this overture for Breslau and incorporated a number of student songs, some of them venerable, like Auger Amos Gigator at the end, some actually rather less venerable. So it's a mark of Brahms's good humour that he weaves them in to a masterly structure throughout the piece. So to begin with these two little pieces by Mozart, and then I won't speak again. So thank you all very much for coming, ladies and gentlemen.